Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you'll learn about using mobile bid adjustments in Google AdWords. I'll walk through how you can apply mobile bid adjustments in your AdWords account and Google's recommendation for selecting a mobile bid adjustment. Overall, bid adjustments allow to modify your final bids based on how your ad is being viewed. Apart from mobile bid adjustments, you can also modify bids based on location, schedule, if people are on a remarketing list, and more. Let's get started. You can adjust your final bids based on the different devices people use to view your ads. A mobile bid adjustment is where you choose to adjust the bid for people using mobile devices. This allows to control costs without needing to create separate mobile-only campaigns. Or in other words, using a mobile bid adjustment can streamline account management by providing optimal bids without increasing the time needed to manage and optimize your campaigns. By default, there'll be no mobile bid adjustment applied to your campaigns. This means that the bids will be the same across all the devices people use to see your ads. For example, if you had a default bid of $1 and a 0% mobile bid adjustment, then the final bid for mobile devices would be $1. Google AdWords allows you to adjust bids up or down. You can increase your final mobile bid by 900% or decrease it by 100%. For example, if the default bid was still $1 and you adjusted it by an additional 100%, then the final bid for mobile devices would be $2. And setting a mobile bid adjustment of minus 100% will prevent your ads from showing to people using mobile devices. You can apply different mobile bid adjustments to each of your campaigns inside Google AdWords. Here we can see we're choosing to increase the final bid for campaigns that are suited to our mobile audience. We can also decrease the final bid if the campaign doesn't perform well on mobile. You also have the option of applying mobile bid adjustments at the campaign and ad group levels for more granular control of your final bids. Here we can see the campaign has an overall mobile bid adjustment of minus 25%. This means that with a default bid of $1, our bid would reduce to 75 cents for mobile users. If we then have a mobile bid adjustment applied at the ad group level, this overrides the campaign level adjustment. So here we can see the ad group level bid would increase from $1 to become $2. The ad group level adjustment has been applied since it's more granular and the campaign level adjustment is ignored. To adjust your mobile bids, navigate to Devices and then click to edit the row that corresponds to the campaign you want to adjust. You have the option of adjusting bids for mobile, tablet, and desktop devices. You can then choose to increase or decrease the bid and click Save. To modify bid adjustments at the ad group level, click the Level Campaign and then select Ad Group. Finally, let's look at Google's recommendation for setting mobile bid adjustments. The idea is to increase your mobile bid adjustment if a conversion is more likely on a mobile device and decrease the bid if a conversion is less likely. So we take our mobile conversion rate, divide it by the desktop conversion rate and subtract one. Here's an example. We can see the mobile conversion rate is 4.43% and the desktop conversion rate is 3.96%. Since the mobile conversion rate is higher than desktop, this means we should increase our mobile bids by 12% to account for the difference. So that's how you can adjust bids for people viewing your ads on mobile devices. If you set multiple bid adjustments, for example, if you set a mobile bid adjustment and a location bid adjustment, then it's important to know that they will be combined. This means that our final bid can be higher or lower than your default bid once the adjustments have been applied. The maximum combined bid adjustment will never exceed more than 900% of the default bid. Are you using mobile bid adjustments? Do you have a bid adjustment tip you'd like to share? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.